I'm vlogging here.
Does my hair look stupid? I feel like it looks stupid. I should have cut my hair. Why do I get so attached to my hair? It looks ugly and stringy, and I have to go to the red carpet of the Monsters University premiere and have this long, ugly, wet, stringy hair. Oh, shit, you're numbskull.
What do you think?
I'm agreeing with you.
I don't know what it is, but I grow my hair long, and I like it long, but it looks ugly. I have to admit.
What do you guys see? What are you looking at?
Blump.
There's a blump?
A blump? No,
what's a blump? Don't call your mom a blimp. She's gained a few pounds, but she's pregnant, you guys. That's so rude. You guys, you're gonna hurt her feelings. Oh, there's a blimp right there. It's one of the minions from the new movie, but we're not talking about that animated movie. We're talking about Pixar Animation Studios, their new movie, Monsters University. We are going to the premiere right now at the famed El Capitan Theater in Hollywood. Who's excited? Taylor Swift's excited. This is a Taylor Swift inspired headband that we are rocking today. Who's Taylor Swift?
Mike Wazowski.
You want to go see Mike Wazowski?
Mike
Wazowski.
So I just tweeted and asked some of you guys to help me with questions of what I should ask the actors. And, you know, I'm a little nervous. Because you go on the red carpet and you got a microphone. It's like, you don't want to ask them the same question. They always get asked over and over. What was your inspiration for your character? It's like, come on. I got to think of something better than that. And then they're going to just be looking at my stupid, stringy, gross hair. I want to wear a hat. I brought my hat. So I'm going to see if they'll let me wear a hat. I doubt it. You can't wear a hat on the red carpet. Oh, white shit, I got a haircut. Do we have time? Can we get a haircut? Is it too late? It's too late. It's too late.
It's too late.
Why won't they let you have a hat on the red carpet?
Dude, social norms, man. I gotta follow the social norms. You can't wear hats on the red carpet.
Why?
I'm not that big of a celebrity yet. If you're a huge celebrity, then you can do whatever you want. But I'm just a nobody asking questions, so I have to follow the social norms, which is like looking nice.
So you'll be that guy?
What guy?
That guy with the hat.
Yeah, you don't want to be like disrespect the carpet. If you're wearing a hat on the red carpet, it looks like you don't care. And it's okay to not care if you're a big celebrity, but if you're not a big celebrity, you have to follow the social norms. Does that make sense?
No. It doesn't.
Sure.
Maybe I should just not care and wear a hat. What will Billy Crystal say? What will John Goodman say, who've been in the film and entertainment industry for 50 years? They see some schmuck with a beard wearing a hat, like I'm disrespecting their craft. You know what I'm saying?
No. Maybe they'll be wearing hats.
I would love it if they were. Dude, that's why I'm going to bring my hat. If I see anybody wearing a hat.
I think if you wore, if you got one of those Monsters University caps.
Oh, rat monkeys. I was about to buy a Pixar hat when we were there and I didn't. Dang it, that would have been my one out. If I had a Pixar hat.
You guys, here we are inside the El Capitan Theater, which is such a cool place. If you guys remember a vlog from when we very first moved to California, we came here and saw Up. And Princess Star danced on that stage. Who remembers that vlog, huh? Huh, Shane? Link it. So you know all that talk about the red carpet? I was wrong, because this is a Pixar movie, and we are on the blue carpet, ladies and gentlemen. That's right, it is blue.
Here we are, Monsters University world premiere tailgate party, and it's college game day. But it's college scare day.
So this is the red carpet. I am on it. But wait, it's not a red carpet. The red carpet's almost become an adjective, like a place, a destination. This is the blue carpet. Here we are.
There's Monsters University, and you guys want to see where my spot is? I'm right there. Shay Carl, YouTube. That's me. Shay Carl on YouTube. And of course, we're right in Jimmy Kimmel's front yard. He's hanging out in there practicing his show for tonight. Jimmy Kimmel live! Can't wait. Hopefully I get to meet Billy Crystal, man. Billy Crystal.
Because Monsters University is like college themed, they're having a tailgate party with all these games, like, you know, throwing balls, which are eyeballs. So the kids are gonna be hanging out over here playing and all this stuff. There's like booths and food and all kinds of stuff. They're gonna be partying. You guys, I came up with a solution. Check it out right here on the right outside.
The thing, words and stuff. Check it. I can wear that.
That's not disrespecting the red carpet. If you're wearing a hat of the movie that the people are in, perfect. It worked out.
Hi, sir. I need to trade you money for this merchandise.
So you guys, that's a life lesson. Thank you. I appreciate it. If you have a problem with ugly hair, a hat will always fix it. I like it. I think it's nice. This is like my favorite style too, like the baseball hat, the round brim, huh? MU baby, all the way, I'm MU! So I'm just waiting to start the red carpet. Colette and the kids are here. Hey, what do you think?
Ugly hair problem solved. What do you think?
Oh, that's cool.
You like it? What?
That's
what do you got? Oh, you got your wristband?
Yeah.
That's gonna get you into the tailgate party. You guys got your wristbands on?
I got my wristband.
You like,
it looks like
do you like daddy's hat? Who's on his daddy's hat?
Look. On forehead.
On forehead. Here, you want to wear it? Put that baby on. Wear that Mike Wazowski hat.
Look,
Mikowski. Put it on. Let's see you wear that thing. Yeah, dude. Nice. Looking cool. MU, baby.
Dad, will that be disrespecting the red carpet?
No, man, because this is the movie that I'm going to see, so it's perfect.
Take my hat. Give me 10 kisses. Stealing my hat.
Hello.
Hello. Cool hat, man.
Nothing more entertaining than finding your own reflection.
Hi! Alright, we're about to go on the red carpet.
Blue carpet! Blue! I gotta remember. I keep calling it the red carpet, Pat. Oh, wait. Pat, what's your nephew's name?
Cole Mitchell.
Cole, I'm here with your uncle, Pat. He's the best. And he has...
Freak out.
Show him your teeth, Pat. Look, I get compliments on my teeth a lot. Pat, some great chompers on this man.
Listen to your grandma.
He is a handsome young man.
And it wouldn't be a tailgate party if you didn't have a Monsters University pep band. Here they come. MU all the way. Woo!
There's so much to see. This is exciting. Who's coming next?
Are you looking at the cheerleaders?
You see, the cheerleaders? You watching the cheerleaders, bro? That's what I did.
Hey, what's going on? Shay Carl here on the blue carpet for the Monsters University premiere. We're hoping to see Billy Crystal tonight. It is hot. We are seeing the sun and feeling its effects. I am sweating profusely in many cracks and crevices of my body.
Okay, bye. Give me a kiss.
Bye, Dad.
Give me a kiss. Feel bad for these cheerleaders. It is hot and sweaty out with a chance of sweatiness.
Okay.
Rotate.
Here she goes. She's gonna be a Monsters University cheerleader. How cute.
Here we are, right on the blue carpet with the MU Pep Squad. Give me five.
Yeah.
I always wanted to date a cheerleader.
All right, so we're on the green carpet, actually, of Monsters University tailgate party, and this is awesome. There's so much food going on. Poor Shay, he has to do the boring part on the blue carpet, where he just interviews, like, celebrities that are really awesome and cool and everything. But we get to eat food!
And then the kids are making a craft. Are you guys turning into monsters?
Yep.
This is awesome.
I'm sorry, but I'm turning into a monster today.
Oh, no. As long as you're a cute monster, I'll take you home with me, okay?
Hello, everybody. Shay Carl right here live on the blue carpet for the Monsters University premiere. We got cheerleaders. We got a tailgate party. We got a pep band. We got MU all the way. I'm repping the hat. There's even going to be like an ESPN college scare day right here from the sports desk. They're going to be calling the shots as they see them, as the celebrities come down the red carpet. It's not red. That was a trick. It's blue. Azul, as they say in Ol Espanol. And we're excited to be here. Let's go.
Give you an idea of the magnitude, how many people are out here on Hollywood Boulevard. There he is, the star of everything, Mike Wazowski! Look at that eyeball. Never looked better, Mike. Never looked better. So handsome. Best looking guy on the carpet. Best looking guy.
There's Sully right here on the blue carpet. Hey, Sully! Love you in Monsters University, man! Woo! MU all the way! Guarantee whoever's inside that suit right now hates their life. Back to you, Shay. Oh, that's me. Oh my gosh, you guys, it's one of my favorite YouTubers, Glozell. Glozell! Hey, Glozell! Hi! Glozell! That's not her. That's not Glozell. That is not Glozell. I think Glozell's in Egypt right now. Dang it. Struck out again.
Okay, you guys, remember this guy? This guy was in the vlog. He did all the animation.
Shay.
What's up, buddy? Good to see you. Good luck tonight. I hope everybody laughs multiple times. All right, see ya.
Yeah, remember he was in our last vlog. He showed us how all the animation works. He's worked on this film for 5 years. What a great night for him. Think, he's walking in here thinking, I've worked on this film for 5 years. This is his big moment. I hope he has a great time.
Hey, Gwen.
Say hi to China, Gwen.
Love you, Gavin. Seriously, I listen to all your songs, sophomore year through senior year, on repeat. Love you, buddy. Glycerin!
Any Bush fans out there? That's Gavin Rossdale. You know, warm sun, feed me up, right? Dude, seriously, in Trevor White's truck, every day we go out to lunch, we listen to Bush all the time, right there. And Gwen Stefani. That was awesome.
Troy, what's up, buddy? Love your hair, man. And your tackling. Your tackling's better than your hair. But your hair's pretty great.
He tackles people really hard, and then he shows them his handsome hair. Troy Polamalu. Pittsburgh Steelers right there. We have NBA legend Scottie Pippen. I hate him because I wanted the Jazz to win. Scottie Pippen! What's up, man? Good. I was rooting for the Jazz the whole time. Karl Malone and John Stockton. I'm sorry.
I hope you lose in the past, which won't happen. Dang it. 98, Scottie Pippen, you broke my heart. And you didn't even stop to talk to me. So you broke it twice, Scottie Pippen. You've broken my heart twice, and for the last time. Break my heart once, shame on me. Break my heart twice, go Jazz.
Third part, what are you making?
Car.
You are pounded hard, dude.
Is that a Monsters University car?
That's cool. Oh, careful, don't put your fingers there, dude.
That is cool.
Look at our pretty little monsters. Now do this. Okay, we got another adorable monster.
You're so cute. Look at your googly eyes. Look at Rock Hard. Oh my goodness. Good job, dude. He's making a card.
Look, he's got a little builder's apron on. So, oh, cotton candy. I can't build now. I got cotton candy. That's more important.
Yeah, just shove it all in and then keep building, okay, bro? That's your energy. I guess we're done building a car. We found cotton candy instead.
Lee Corso, Desmond Howard, hosts of College Game Day here on the blue carpet today. What are you guys most excited about?
Go ahead, tell them, Lee.
Lee?
Meeting Billy Crystal.
Right? Where is he? Have you seen him yet?
I don't know, but I hope he comes because he's my favorite.
So listen, you're going to be at the desk right there, and he's going to come walking by. Do not be ashamed to yell out, Billy! Billy! You got to yell at him. He'll come over there.
Okay, we may have to do that because we can't let this opportunity pass us by.
It's a once in a life.
I might ask him a question about the Yankees.
There you go, right? He's a classic Yankees fan.
Three games behind everything.
So, last question, who's going to win in this series? We're game six, Spurs, Heat. Who do you guys have your money on?
Well, I'm a Miami resident, so go Heat. Right? Hey, Demir, Desmond.
You guys, Kobe or LeBron?
Heat or the Spurs? Heat or the Spurs?
Heat.
That's right. Kobe or LeBron?
LeBron.
Nice. You've indoctrinated them well.
Thank God. Miami's going to win it because the television people need a seventh game.
That's right. They're hoping for this game seven, right? Thanks for stopping by, guys. Good luck out there today. Take it easy. They're going to be doing the Scare Day. Instead of College Game Day, it's College Scare Day. Get it? It's like a play on words because it's a scary movie. Hey, Charlie. Shay Carl. Charlie Day from Always Sunny in Philadelphia here. You are my favorite character in the whole movie, Pat.
Up top.
Up top.
Most comic relief. The you have like five or six one-liners. They're like, ha, that's hilarious.
Well, that, you know, I'm only good for about five or six lines, but then, you know, if they hit, I'm in good shape.
Now, I'm going to make a prediction right now. I'm going to say after this movie is everywhere and everybody's downloaded it, watched it 100 times, and all the kids, there's going to be favorite monster contests. And Pat, mark my words, when you guys see the movie, Pat's going to be your favorite monster.
My monster's Art, but I'm sure this Pat character you're talking about is...
Oh, my hellfire and damnation. Art.
Is that the guy you met?
That's you. That's Art. I said Pat. I'm an idiot. It's Art.
It's more important.
Yeah. No, it was. The big guy, the line, like, I can't go back to jail again, and you run off. And then, like, the line where you come downstairs and you guys were all, like, in the frat house. There's so many good lines. I've worked with Danny DeVito recently on a project, and what's it like working with him every day?
Well, Danny, you know, the guy's insane, but he's the best. He's got more energy than people half his age, and he's tough to keep up with, but I love him. I love him like a brother and like a father. He's the best.
All right, man. Thanks for stopping by. Art! Art! Hilarious! It's going to be your favorite monster. You wait and see. Take my word for it. Oh, I called him Pat. What an idiot. I'm an idiot. Fail one on the blue carpet. Gall. Hey, it's the guy from the movie with The Rock where he owned the casino and The Rock beat the crap out of him. It's that guy. I love that movie. Remember, The Rock had like a big 2x4, and that guy had a casino, and he was ruining the town. And like Dwayne The Rock Johnson came in and beat him up and all of his cohorts. Yeah, I love you, The Rock. I don't love this guy. He ruins towns. He's a town ruiner. Look at him in his town ruining jeans. Yeah, I wish The Rock was here right now with a 2x4. Don't tell him I said that. Here's my extent of celebrity knowledge. Oh, look, it's that one girl from that one thing. Remember that show with the movie? Hey! And that's how I roll on the blue carpet. Hey, guys.
Sashka.
Mark, good to meet you. So, thank you. You like that? I hated my hair, and I thought, I wish I could wear a hat, and then I found this one. So it worked out perfect. So if you guys have ever seen a Pixar movie, which you have, don't be ridiculous, one of the features that they always have is they have a little animated short before. These two made an amazing one that you will see, and it's called The Blue Umbrella. It's right before Monsters University. My wife... And I kind of made fun of her a little bit for this. I'm like, honey, it's an animated short. She thought it was real, like the rain gutter and stuff. It looks very realistic.
amazing. We love to hear people trick people a little bit, but this is all animation. Just shows that animation can be anything.
So it's all, there's no like shots, you don't film anything?
Zero.
No, it's all animation. And our idea was we wanted the audience to think, oh, this is live action, this is real. And then have them be surprised when things come to life, because you can be surprised if you first think it's real.
It makes the city that much more magical. When it
totally was. Like when the rain gutter like smiles and then like the thing comes out, I'm like, I think they maybe like really built that and then like stretched it or something, because it was so real.
Love it. It's the highest compliment you can pay us. Thank you.
Yes. And it's a great love story, too. It was. It was like you were rooting for that little umbrella. You wanted those umbrellas to find true love.
When you saw it, did the theater go silent when he hit the car?
Yes. It was like, oh, and there's like a little gasp, a collective gasp. Yeah, it was great. And to be able to put that much story into such short of a clip, you guys are very talented. All right. Thanks, guys. You guys are amazing. Appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
Check out the digital short right before the creators. Dude, the Jared, the Subway guy. I want to talk to him. Fellow weight loss dudes. I lost 100 pounds. What do you lose? Like 150 pounds? Jared,
yes, sir.
From Subway.
How are you?
What's going on? I'm Shay. Thank you. I have also lost 110 pounds.
No.
I did. I was 283 pounds. There's no secret. Just working your butt off, yeah. You know.
Absolutely. I hear you.
Serious question for you. Are you sick of Subway yet?
Never. How would you ever say such
don't
a word?
Don't lie to me, Jared. Are you sick of it?
Shay, let me tell you right now. No, no, no. I don't eat it every single day anymore, but I still eat it 2 or 3 times a week. If it's not broke, don't fix it, I say. And it really helps me keep the weight off. I travel 200 days a year with Subway all over the world. And, you know, you're eating out all the time, you got to be careful. And eating room service and getting to hotels late at night, it's nice to still depend on Subway. And honestly, I do. And when I go to Subway, I still eat the low-fat sandwiches, and so far, it's 15 years into this, so I've kept the weight off.
It's crazy it's been that long, 15 years. I remember being in Subway, yeah, like when I was a senior, and there was like a big cardboard cutout with you, and I'm like, dude, that guy was fat. He looked at all that weight he lost.
You're going to make me feel old now. See, I go to schools, and I speak to these kids, these high school kids, yeah. And they were babies when I started doing this, so nothing like bringing my head down from the clouds, but no, it's true. It's been awesome. People say that Jared guy can do it. I can do it, too, and God bless America.
15 years, man, to be able to keep it off for that long, it's tough. I tell, like, it starts to creep back on if you're not careful, if you don't watch.
It is, and the older you get, I mean, I'm 35 now. When I hit 30,
you're 35? Oh, sweet, I'm 33.
Okay, well,
I don't know what that means, but anyways, we're close in age.
We're
friends! Woo, MU all the way! So my question is, then, when it starts to creep on, do you get, like, a call from, like, the head dude at Subway, be like, Jared, we can see it. You're starting to get chubby again. No, watch it, buddy.
I get it from my belt buckle. I can always tell my belt. I'm like, all right, I can't be going past that one notch. That's just not going to work.
So, like that spot.
You know, I try to nip it in the bud like Barney Fife always said, and so far it hasn't been an issue. And my goal in life is to make sure it never becomes an issue.
There you go. Well, you're looking great, man. Have a great time tonight. Good to meet you.
See you.
Jared from Subway. Cool dude. And looking handsome. Look at his butt in those chains. His butt looks nice. Here with Wayne Brady, who was on the Daytime Emmys last night, talking about Let's Make a Deal.
Yeah.
Listen, man, I got to tell you, well, maybe I can't tell you the story because your daughters are here, but when you were on Whose Line Is It Anyway, I was at my friend's house with his parents, and you know what? I can't tell this story. Never mind.
Now it's really intriguing, isn't it?
Okay, so there was a scene where you had to do a pornography scene, and you started going, bow, chicka, bow, wow, and all me and my friends started cracking up, and my friend's mom is like, what? I don't get it. And I blurted out, have you ever seen a... Never mind. Anyways, Wayne Brady, hilarious.
I'm more mad at mom for never having lived a little. Yeah, mom, watch a movie too. You know, they don't need to know what kind.
So you guys excited to see the movie?
Yeah.
Do you think you're gonna like this one or the first one better?
Yeah.
A very non-committal yes to both.
Yeah. Well, it's good. I've seen it. You guys are gonna love it. Your dad is hilarious. Your daughters, right?
This is my daughter Miley, and this is my niece Sophia.
What a cousin, huh? Best friends bringing you on the blue carpet. You having a good time?
Yeah.
Right?
Her very first premiere, so she's super excited. So we're going to go in there, and I'm going to let them play around, and then we're going to catch the movie, and they're going to stuff themselves full of junk food.
Candy.
Exactly.
All right, thanks, Wayne. You're so talented, man. Hilarious. One of the funniest guys on TV ever and will be.
Hey,
a lot of good stuff.
Look out for Whose Line starting July 16th on the CW. It's back.
No way. Yeah, you heard it right here.
So in your honor, there'll be more boom chicka boom.
I'm loving it. Wayne Brady, thanks, man. Appreciate it. Dude, that dude is hilarious. Here I am with Bobby Moynihan from Saturday Night Live.
Here I am with Shay Carl.
What? You knew my name.
Can you believe it?
Bearded Bobby.
Yeah.
Liking the beard, man. It's hot out here, right?
Yeah. I hope I don't ever have to shave again.
Do they, at Saturday Night Live, do they ask you to shave it or do they like you to keep it?
Yeah, I can't play like Rosie O'Donnell with a beard.
I've tried, but they
won't. I don't know. In these later years, Rosie, you might need. No, just kidding. Rosie,
she's the best. She's going to get us, man. Be careful. Watch out. Here comes Rosie, Bobby.
So, dude, what was it like? Because Saturday Night Live, it's such an iconic show to be on. And I feel like once you're on Saturday Night Live, you've made it. You know what I mean? Like, you just, yeah. you're on Saturday Night Live for 5 or 6 years and you start getting in movies. And yeah, pretty soon, I mean, you're famous and you're rich and famous. How does it feel?
Yeah, rich and famous. Sure. That's how I describe myself.
Can I borrow $10,000?
Yeah. Can I? No, I'm very happy. I mean, that was my life's dream. And now to be in a Pixar movie, I'm done.
Right.
I'm going to bed tonight. It's over.
You've made it. You made it. Oh, well, yeah. That's another thing I was going to say is being in a Pixar movie, it almost doesn't matter what you've done, but it's like you're in a Pixar movie. Everybody knows.
I have an action figure.
Right.
That's all that matters.
That's every kid's little dream.
Yeah,
so I want to know, when they called you and you said, Bobby, you're on SNL, what was that like? Where were you at? What did you scream? What were you wearing?
I was in bed. I was asleep. And Lauren called and told me, I don't remember a single word from the conversation at all.
Really?
And then 10 minutes after I hung up, Seth Meyers texted me saying congrats. And I was like, oh, I did get it. And then I ran across the street to where my mom works in a pair of boxer shorts.
That's a great story.
That's
a great story. All right, man. Well, congrats. You're hilarious. Thank love you on SNL.
You're the best.
Good job at Pixar. And love this guy.
Pretty great.
All right. Thanks, man.
Beard brothers.
Let's rub them. Is that weird?
Oh, it might
is that
be
weird?
A tiny
bit. Weird. All right.
Not
thanks.
For me. For
right.
Everyone
everybody watching. Okay, turn off the camera. You're going to have to rub our beards together.
Nice
all right,
to
man.
You, man.
Appreciate it. Appreciate it. Bobby Moynihan. He's met probably every famous person there is. Think about it. Think about this. At the end of every Saturday Night Live, what do? They hang around on stage and they talk to the other celebrities. They're like, oh, and I always want to know, what are they saying? That's what I should have asked Bobby Moynihan when he was just right here. Dang it!
Not a big deal, but there's Gwen Stefani's here.
She's right over here, look. Her kids are building stuff at the building station. This is so fun.
I built a car.
So cool. That's an awesome car, dude.
Hey, Rock Hard. He's jumping into Mike's eyeballs. Hey! Hi! Are you bouncing in the eyeball? Yeah, go down the slide again, okay? Woo! Into the giant bat of eyeballs. And there he goes! You're up next, dude. You ready?
Ready to rock and roll. And there's Baby Tard.
We'll find him on the other end!
Oh, there's Rock Hard climbing to the top! Woo! Oh! Super scary, dude! And there's Baby Tard into the giant vat of eyeballs!
Hi, Bobby! Bobby!
This is amazingly fun. I wish I wasn't pregnant, then I would jump right in there.
Okay, girls, do it again. Oh, yeah, you did it! Hey, Baby Tard! Oh, man. Yes, yes, yes! Good job, honey.
It's a kid from Modern Family. Just walked by. That was cool, huh? I'm sweaty. Hey, John.
Hi.
Good to meet you, man.
Are
good to meet
Shay?
You. I'm Shay. Yes.
Can you sing?
Oh, Danny boy, the pipes are calling from mountain. Nope, that's all I know. Glen to Glen. Dang it, I'm a bad Irish.
No, that's actually an English song.
Oh, is it?
That is a Welsh song, yeah.
So I don't know if the folks at home know this, but he has been in every single Pixar movie ever made. He's their good luck charm.
I think this is 14.
Is it number 14?
Yeah, I think at 15 I get my own parking space.
Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
I like your dress. It matches the carpet.
Thank you. You know, if I lie down on the carpet, you would only see my pale vampire skin. So
did you know it was going to be blue?
Yes, I got it. Well, I got like on the invitation it said wear Monsters University colors, and I'm like,
done.
I'm ready. Bam.
Have you seen the movie yet, or you've seen it tonight?
No, I haven't seen it yet, but I've been talking to a bunch of people who've already seen it, and I'm so jealous. I've wanted to see this so badly.
It's hilarious. I saw it. It's close to being better than the first one. I don't know. I'm interested to see if you think
the first one was literally amazing. So now my expectations are super high.
Pixar does that. They make these amazing films and then they have to top themselves, which is difficult.
I've been the biggest fan of Monsters University. So, and I'm so excited to see, you know, all my Disney Channel peeps and other peeps that I know. So yeah.
I'm looking forward to seeing Eden Cher. I think she's coming down the carpet.
Oh, hey. I love her. Oh my God, are you kidding me? Yes, yeah. She's so funny. She's so talented.
She really is. Do you know Nathan Kress?
Well, I don't know him personally. I know of him, and I hear he is the sweetest guy.
He's handsome. I have his phone number. I can text him. Oh, would you like me to hook you up with Nathan?
Well, you know, I would actually want you to hook me up with George Clooney. Can you make that happen?
She likes the older dudes.
I mean, he's just perfect. He's the Clooneymeister.
George! He's coming. I think he's just down
George,
there. The Clooneymeister.
Hey, I'm normal. What's going on? Or Harry Potter, the character. I know he's not, like, real. He's a fictional character, but make it happen. I believe you.
Wingardium Leviosa. Wingardium, you make out with Harry Potter. Or something. All right, thank you. Nice to meet you. Have fun tonight.
Thanks.
Billy Crystal, there he is. There he goes. Billy Crystal just walked by, and we had this moment. And I know you guys are saying, whatever, Shay. But there was a moment where we met eyes, and it was like when Harry met Sally, and he looked at her that one time, that same look. I've never seen it before other than that movie when Harry met Sally, but he just looked at me, and we had this moment. I love you, Billy. Mike Wazowski, come give me 5. Yeah, bring that eyeball over here. Woohoo! Nice. Thanks, Mike. I just gave Mike Wazowski high five. Whoa, Victoria's Secret supermodel. What's her name? Alessandra Ambrosia. I'm a happily married man, but you are gorgeous. She's like, restraining order. Bye, Alessandra. I love you. Her and Billy, they both gave me those looks. You know what I'm talking about. Eat and share. What's going on? Bring it in.
Come here.
I haven't seen you forever. Good. Hey, guys. What's up? Really? Come here, Charlie. Look at that hair, man. I saw that all the way down the red carpet. Wait a minute. It's blue. My mistake. Eat and share from the middle. We last time hung out, we were on the red carpet at the American Music Awards.
Yes. I'm so happy to see you.
What have you been up to?
I've been,
besides acting on TV and being famous.
TV celebrity.
I love your celebrity.
I've been working on actually a website that
there
I have launched.
There you go. I told her, I'm like, you got to get on the web, the www.
You know that I'm trying to get involved with Maker Studios.
What? What?
Oh my God. I'm going to use this time to
schmooze. You should. I'm one of the co-founders of Maker Studios. I could help you in that effort.
I know. Maybe we don't. Maybe we can talk about it later. But
no, I want you to sign this contract right now.
Right? It's on camera.
For sure. We should do something together.
I know.
A web series.
I'm working on a web series with my friend. Actually, this is my best friend's little brother, the guy with the crazy hair.
I love his hair. We've shaken hands twice now. Let's take it to another level. Yeah. This is our shake from now on. Now shimmer it down. Shimmer it down. All right. Well, we'll talk. Tweet me. We'll do something together. Come to Maker Studios. I'll give you a tour. You want a tour?
Please.
Come to Maker.
I'm making a web series, and you're gonna have to do something with
it. I'll be in it. I'll tweet it. I'll Facebook it. Yeah. I'll YouTube it. I'll do it all.
Awesome. All right.
Watch the movie. You guys are gonna love it. Good to see you. Good to meet you. Oh, bring it in. I love this guy's hair. I wanna touch it. Can I touch it?
Yes.
So cool. Eden Cher. She's great. We're friends. I love her. You guys, I am interviewing Billy Crystal right now on the blue carpet. Billy, so what was your favorite part about the movie? That's hilarious, Billy. You always know just what to say. So, Billy, what is your favorite line in the whole movie? Totally, totally. I cracked up when you said that in the movie. That was hilarious. So it's been 11 years since the original Monsters University. What's it like coming back 11 years afterwards? Totally. I know what you're saying. Man, Billy Crystal, best interview I've ever done. Thanks, Billy. I think we're going to get in some shot here. I'm just going to kind of like blend in here. Don't tell anybody.
It's great to be with you. Tell us, Mike.
Mike is my favorite character I've ever played in anything. Yeah, because I love that he's a little guy in a big man's world. A lot of courage, great sense of humor, and is a positive thinker. I think that's it. He's a great role model.
I don't know what this is called, but he's about to do it.
Great job, you guys. Now, let's see who's ready to do it again. Here on.
We're gonna teach you our scariest cheer.
Oh yeah.
Back up.
Do it.
Woo!
would love a picture.
Oh, sorry, mom's not ready. Mom's slow. Okay. Yay! Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Well, who had a good time?
Me.
Did this little guy have a good time?
He ate a lot of food.
Did he have some Cinnabons?
I tried to stop him, but he was just like, "No, I'm hungry, mom." So I just.
Yeah, he looks like he's getting bigger.
It's getting bigger.
It's Mommy Tart is past the halfway point. She's got a little monster hanging out in her monster belly.
My 5-month appointment is this week, so.
You guys have a good time?
Yeah!
Baby Tart, what are you wearing? Oh, you look adorable. Look at you. Did you have fun? What was your favorite part?
We got this. It's because, you know, the pink girl and the purple girl?
Yeah, the pink girl and the purple girl. Right?
We got to dance with
them. We got to dance with them and do the cheers and maybe the pom poms.
Well, that was a lot of fun. What?
I'm worried this and supported Monsters University.
That was very good of you to do that. All right, let's go pick up Uncle Logan.
Yay!
You guys want to go pick up Uncle Logan?
Yes!
We have to head to LAX now and pick up Uncle Logan. He's moving to LA to hang out for a few months. We're excited!
Oh, Shay, you're back! Oh, wait. Oh, it's Logan!
Logan
there! We missed you so much, brother.
He's got his skateboard.
Well, get in before we get stopped by the cops again.
It's true. It wasn't my fault. It was all Shay's fault. Seriously.
How was your flight?
Dude, it was weird. There was a medical emergency on it, and they asked for doctors.
That happened to me last time.
There was a lady having contractions.
Uh-oh. What? I thought that only happened in movies.
Yeah, no.
So wait, was she going, like, in labor contractions?
It was kind of bad. She was, like, 4 rows back from me, and I was asleep at the time, and then we got on the PA, and they're like, "We have a medical emergency. Are there any doctors or nurses on board?" I wish I would have had my camera or something.
But said, no, like, but I'm a YouTuber. I can film it.
I have my GoPro.
I'll get the baby on camera, I promise.
I'll hook up this GoPro to one of the fallopian tubes. We'll get a great shot. We'll do some slow-mo, get some Skrillex in here, make a great music video.
Skrillex? No, but I look back, and she had her legs like this on the seat, and I thought she was, like, going into labor.
She could have the baby? And show us how was that, Logan?
She was going
how did
like
she
this.
Ever... Okay, was she dilated past like a 6, do you know?
I wasn't looking.
Did you get down there and see?
She was like 3 rows back and everybody was like staring and getting up. And then like 3 doctors like raised their hand and then there was a nurse on board.
Good.
Yeah, there was a nurse, there was 2 nurses and then there was 1 doctor and he specialized in delivery and stuff, but he calmed her through and they gave her water and stuff and it was good.
Perfect.
That's awesome. So she didn't have a baby.
No.
Darn it, that would have been fun.
I know, I was going to be like, there's going to be a baby on my plane.
That's the worst, sitting next to a baby on the plane. Am I right?
That's worse than snakes on a plane.
Boom shakalaka, there you go, 34 minutes of Shay Tart's entertainment for your faces. You know it'd be super sweet and swell as if you guys got 1,000 thumbs up for every minute of this vlog. That means 34,000 thumbs up. Can you do it? Yes, you guys, you got 31,000 on the last vlog where we went to Pixar. So once again, we had this amazing, amazing opportunity to go hang out at the world premiere of the new Pixar movie, Monsters University. Such a cool time. The kids had a blast. I got to meet so many cool people, and we feel so blessed to be able to be part of this whole thing. Check out the movie. It comes out June 21st. If you want to click on the mystery video, I'll link you to the last time when we actually went to Pixar and we got to see their Oscars. Check out yesterday's vlog and click right there in the middle to see what the Shay Tarts were doing 1, 2, 3, and 4 years ago. We have been making a video every single day for the last 4.5 years. If you haven't, hit that subscribe button and we will see you tomorrow. Call me Billy Crystal.